business is definitely business. But just listen for a minute. You don't understand this. When I was a boy, 18, 19, I was already on the road. There was a question in my mind as to whether selling had a future for me. Because in those days, I had a yearning to go to Alaska. See, there were 3 gold strikes in 1 month in Alaska. And I felt like going out. Just for the ride, you might say. Oh, yeah. My father lived there for many years in Alaska. He was an adventurous man. We've got quite a little streak of self-reliance in our family. I thought I'd go out with my older brother and try to locate him. Maybe settle in the north with the old man. I had almost decided to go when I met a salesman at the Parker House. His name was Dave Singleman. He was 84 years old. He'd drummed merchandise in 31 states. Old Dave. He'd go up to his room, you understand, put on his green velvet slippers. I'll never forget it. He'd pick up his phone and call the buyers without ever leaving his room. At the age of 84, he made his living. When I saw that, I realized that selling was the greatest career a man could want. Because what could be more satisfying than to be able to go at the age of 84 into 20 or 30 different cities, pick up the phone and remember, and love, and help by so many different people. You know, when he died, by the way, he died in death in the city. Green velvet slippers, a smoker, New York, New Haven, Hartford, going into Boston. He died, hundreds of salesmen acquired the rents. Things were sad, a lot of trains, a lot of sex. See, in those days, personality was it. There was respect, comradeship, gratitude. Today, it's all cut and dry. No chance of bringing friendship to bear or personality. You see what I mean?